What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. We're doing an updated guide here for setting up PlayStation 5 remote play on your Steam Deck. This would work for PS4 as well. This is a bit easier and a lot better than what the previous guide was that we made last year based off of the Chiaki app. This will be with Chiaki 4 Deck, and it's fully functional with all the swipes and everything that you need from the touchpad from the PS5. So it's fully functional and able to play all the games, which is great. Now, I have links in the description for you for the GitHub page, though we're not installing it from there. There's plenty of great information to go dive into. And also the Chiaki 4 pages over here, I'll have links to as well. There's things that you can go in there. There's a lot of information that you can go through if you're interested in getting farther into the Chiaki 4 setup. There's things you can do with the automatic launching and that type of stuff that could be helpful. There's other explanations in here as well that could be helpful to you. So this guide's just really going to be getting you started, basically streaming and having full functionality, but if you want to go deeper than that, there's plenty of information here. All right, so over on the Steam Deck, we're in game mode here, and we're going to need to actually be on desktop mode. So we go into a power, we'll go down to switch to desktop, and then that'll go to switched over. Once on desktop mode, I'm going to open up the browser, and I got a couple of things I want to do. Now, PSN account ID from Flip Screen Games here, this will be in the description as well for you. You're going to use your PlayStation username to get the encoder ID that you need for Chiaki. You can also get your PS Play ID that you need from this method as well if you're using Android. Now, if this is for at-home network, if you want to be able to do this away from home, there's a great guide from Overkill Gaming. If you want to go check him out, give that video some love. He explains how to set up away from home. This is focused on in-home network. Now we're going to go to the Discover store because it's time to grab Chiaki 4. So go to Discover, I'm going to search for Chiaki, and it should bring up both versions, the original version and the Chiaki 4 deck here. So there we go. Now my previous video was based off of regular Chiaki, which worked, but it was a bit more cumbersome and wasn't fully functional. Chiaki 4 deck will be more fully functional and it's a lot easier. So I'll click on this, we'll do install, and that'll get us ready to go. That's a really quick process. Once the install is all done, we can launch this and go into the settings, but I don't want to stream my PS5 just yet. So it's going to be sitting here unregistered. I'm not going to bother with it just yet. It's showing up because we're on the same network. I'm going to go over here to settings, and you'll see that there's a few options in here. And if you're using a DualSense controller, there's some experimental features in here for you as well. Some other stuff here with audio, speech processing, all that for mic support. Over there on the right, we have our keys set up for keyboard, which of course will be emulated through controller on the Steam Deck for handheld mode. And then we have our resolution down here, 720p, which you can run great here on the deck, or 1080p. I'm going to start with 1080p here. I think it looks nice even on the deck's 800p screen. And then our bitrate defaults to 15,000. You can experiment with that. I'm going to put 12,000 for now. You know, see what works best for your network and what you need to do. For audio, I'm doing 15,000. Helps with some of the audio snaps and crackles and things that you might get or that you got prior with the other version of Chiaki. All right, so once we have that all done and ready to go, it's just a basic setup just to get things going. We'll do register new, and this is going to get us to register our PS5 here. And the only two things we need is that encoder ID that we had gotten from that website for Chiaki and our PIN from our PS5. So that's the first thing, is I'm going to go copy that real quick, the ID that we had gotten for Chiaki in there. Now I'm going to go on my PlayStation 5 and grab the PIN I need for remote play there. So over on the PlayStation 5, we're going to go over to settings. We're going to come down here and go to system. Then we're going to go to remote play. I already have everything enabled. If you haven't enabled that previously, you want to make sure you've done that. Go to link device and you'll get a temporary PIN that's good for a little while to go put into that PIN slot over there and register on Chiaki. So once you do that, you click register, and then that'll get your PS5 connected. You only have to do that one time here for the setup. Now that we're all connected and good to go, we're going to close out of these settings. But again, before we actually start streaming to PS5, there's a few other things I do want to get into. So we're going to close this, and we're going to go over here and add this to Steam so we can use it in game mode, right? So that makes it easier. So we'll go into Steam here. We're going to go to add a game, and then we're going to go over to add a non-Steam game. Chiaki 4 should show up right in the list here. Just check that off, add selected programs, and that's going to add it to Steam. So we can close out of that. Now the next thing is artwork for me is a big deal on the Steam Deck. So I use Decky Loader for that, for Steam Grid DB. So if you want to skip this, that's fine. But for me, I like to use this for the artwork. So I'm going to do a quick install here. I'm going to download Decky Loader here. I'll also have a link in the description for this site. All kinds of information here if you want to look into installation, uninstall, and all that. A lot of great apps for the Steam Deck. But anyway, I'm going to install this and just use Steam Grid DB real quick for my artwork. So I'm going to go to my downloads folder, double click. We're going to do execute. Then we're going to do continue. and it's going to ask for your admin password. If you haven't already set one up, you can go over into settings and users. You can do change password, and you can set up a password here that you can then use. So we'll set mine up in here real quick. I've recently restored this deck, so everything's pretty fresh here. Set password, and we'll close out of here. And now we can go and put that over here in the Decky installer. And this is a really quick process. We're going to click on release version up here, click OK, and it won't take very long, and it'll also be ready to go here. All right, installation is complete there. We can close out of all of this, and I'm going to get ready to get us out of here. I'm going to go ahead and shut down or restart, and we're going to go into game mode, and we can do everything else from over there, change our artwork, and get into some streaming. All right, let's get moved over here, and we are back to game mode. You can see everything's grayed out, but we have Chiaki 4 Deck in our non-Steam game section here of our library, and we have Decky Loader installed here at the bottom. A lot of great apps that you can get into with Decky Loader. If you're not familiar, I have some videos on the channel, probably have some new ones coming up as well. But to speed this up, let's come down to Steam Grid DB. Love this on Decky Loader. So easy to change all of the artwork for any of your games or apps, and it's a lot easier than doing everything manually like we used to do before. So we've installed that. We're gonna go back and I'll hit start. That's gonna bring up the menu here. You can click change artwork now. You wanna actually search for just Chiaki, not Chiaki 4 Deck. And that'll bring up all these options for you automatically. So I'm gonna go through here and pick my capsule, my wide capsule, my hero, my logo, and my icon. Once you do go through all these and make your choices of what you want it to look like and you get the icon, it's gonna ask you to restart your deck to finish applying everything. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that real quick. We'll get restarted. Now when we come back in, you'll see everything looks nice and clean and we have our artwork. And I just think that's the easiest way to do it. And I love using Decky Loader and Steam Grid DB to do that. Now you will also need this current this layout for your controller, Chiaki 4 Deck Plus Mic from G-Money 23. If you don't already have this, you can go into the layouts. You can go to Community Layouts. Come down here till you find the G-Money 23 Chiaki 4 Deck. This is from the creator of Chiaki 4 Deck and makes everything work properly there for you. All right, so once all that's done, we can go ahead and actually get launched in. So I'm going to switch over to a different view here where I'm actually filming everything. It's not a great setup with the camera, but you'll get the point. You'll be able to see everything here. So we launched Chiaki 4 Deck. Turn down this brightness a little bit to just help us out a little bit here. And we'll double tap, and that's going to get us in. You can set up to where you can do an automatic connect like I was talking about. It's all the information's on their site. But if I just double click here, it won't take very long. We'll take a look at me for a sec, and we will get into streaming our PS5. And there you go. Now we're connected, and this works a lot better than it did for me last year using the original Chiaki setup and situation. And I still am tweaking things to get my input latency where I want. And also, my PS5 isn't hardwired right now. I had to make some changes, and it's on Wi-Fi, and that always adds a little bit. If I go hardwired, there's basically no difference on for my in-home network, but there's a little bit of latency when it comes to my Wi-Fi here. Now you'll see gyro is working, which is really cool. I'm not a person who uses the gyro controls, but I did want to show them off here a little bit. So I'm going to disable them, but that is working automatically here for me with that layout. So I've disabled gyro and everything is now just running normally here, and I'll just use the sticks to move around. And all of this looks really nice on the Steam Deck screen. Again, you could do 720p or 1080p here, adjust the bitrate as you need to. And there's a lot of things that you can really do, and even to your home network to help this run better. And definitely hardwire your PS5 if you can for the upload. Me being on Wi-Fi here always adds a little bit. If you go to hardwired, definitely makes a difference. And I'll probably run another cable to do that since I'm going to be remote playing a good bit here for a while. Now, as far as those swipes, your touchpad here will work. Swipe up for camera, swipe down to disable that, swipe left for your app, and click it for your map or your menu. And that's a big deal to be able to have all that. There's a lot of games on the PlayStation where you need those swipes. Now those back shortcuts, if I hit the bottom one, I get my mic turned on and off automatically. If I hit the other button on the back, I get to bring up the, put the console to sleep, leave the game, whatever here. Super convenient, really easy, nice shortcuts here. So it makes it a fully functional way to stream your PlayStation 5 over to your Steam Deck. And that just makes a big difference. It doesn't so much limit the games like Last of Us, you have some guitar strumming you need to do. You can pull that off. And Ghost of Tsushima, there's like some areas you got to do the wind thing, you got to swipe, you're able to do that. So that makes a big difference where you don't get stuck and held up because of not having full functionality. So between Chiaki 4 Deck and the controller setup and layout here and getting things adjusted on your home network and on your app and your Steam Deck and all that, you can really get yourself a good experience when it comes to streaming your PlayStation 5. It's definitely something I'll be doing a lot more here with Spider-Man 2 out and stuff. I'll be putting in some time, so I really wanted to get into trying this again. But anyways, guys, thanks a lot for coming to check out the video. As always, I really appreciate it. Hit me up in the comments with any questions. Let me know how this is working for you. All the links should be in the description for you. Thanks again for coming to check it out, and I'll see you in the next one.